For the vast majority of our early reproductive life, our primary focus as women is to not get pregnant. And we can spend a number of years using contraceptives like the pill, IDUs and the implant, really being successful at their aim. But unfortunately, there are a number of women who really struggle to get their cycles to return to normal once they stop the contraceptives, just at a time when they are wanting to get pregnant. So in this video, let's talk about how we can get our hormones back on track naturally once we've stopped contraceptive use. For the very best health and wellness tips and tools, subscribe to my channel and hit the bell to be notified whenever I upload a new video. Hi, I'm Leah, the epidemiologist and health improvement specialist behind the Thrive Practice, where I do the detective work necessary to get to the root cause of my clients' symptoms or illnesses so that they can finally start to feel like themselves again. And this channel is all about providing you with evidence-based wellness advice that empowers and inspires you to hack your way to better health. Now, it will of course take some time for your body to get back to normal after what may be as much as a decade or more of suppressing the body's natural reproductive function. And there's also a likelihood that any hormonal issues that were flaring up prior to you starting the contraceptives could also flare up again once you've stopped using them. For some women, it can take anywhere from a few weeks to a few months for their cycles to return to normal after they've stopped using contraceptives. The most common symptoms of which include a lack of a period, irregularities in the menstrual cycle, acne, fertility issues, migraines, and weight gain as well. So what might be behind your off-key menstrual cycles? Well, it's complex and there could be a number of possible causes, but three that are likely include stress, nutritional deficiencies, and an impaired detoxification process. So here are three areas of your lifestyle that you may want to consider looking into. Research suggests that oral contraceptives may deplete the body of a number of vital nutrients, including zinc, selenium, magnesium, folic acid, vitamin B2, vitamin B6, vitamin B12, vitamin C, and vitamin E. And after long-term use of hormonal contraceptives, there may be a number of nutrients that your body is deficient in, and it may be worthwhile getting those investigated through testing and ensuring that you're eating a healthy, balanced diet. Stress is another factor in menstrual cycles, and chronic stress can disrupt the hormones of the hypothalamic-pituitary-adrenal axis. The hypothalamus and pituitary glands are key in regulating menstrual cycles. Therefore, chronic stress can cause irregularities in periods. And you may have noticed this yourself, maybe when you've gone through a stressful emotional or physical experience, whether you're an athlete or you've just gone through stressful exams, etc. So anything that you can do to relieve stress is therefore going to have a positive impact on bringing back your periods. After taking hormonal contraceptives for a long time, what's known as a hormonal buildup can often occur. Now, normally the liver is really great at clearing these hormones out of the body, but if the detoxification process isn't well supported, the liver may struggle and fail in its duty. There are many ways to support the body's natural detoxification processes, but one way would be to eat foods with a higher fiber content. With most fruits and vegetables, you're kind of covered in that respect. But citrus fruits, root vegetables, asparagus, and berries, as well as lentils and chickpeas, are all really good sources of soluble fibers that support the detoxification process of the body. So there you have it, three ways to get your periods and your menstrual cycle back on track after using hormonal contraceptives. And if you want to learn how you can improve a range of common health conditions and symptoms, using evidence-based lifestyle medicine that works, all while getting the support and accountability that you need to make it work for you, then check out thethrivepractice.com. I'll also leave links to my other social channels in the description below. Feel free to reach out to me through one of those too. Don't forget to check out these videos on how to hack your way to better health. And if you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe, and share it with someone who could benefit. I'm sure they'd really appreciate it. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the next one.